Tonight's game is between Kings 11 from Punjab and Sunrisers from Hyderabad, and that's what we're going to talk about on opening salvo. One team, in fact both teams, are looking quite confident. Very decent bowling lineup for both the sides. Let's start with the hosts. They are at their home venue. You have Ravichandran Ashwin, you have Mujib, you have the option of playing Akshar Patel. You can always go to Barinder Sarna. Andrew Tai has been quite good. I think if they end up playing Marcus Stoinis, which may just happen because Aaron Finch hasn't fired yet, they'll have a deeper bowling unit and they'll have plenty of options to play around with. But that's the case with the opponents as well. Sunrisers Hyderabad possesses the best bowling lineup in the IPL 2018. They've got Shakib, Rashid, Bhuvi, that's 12 overs. Billy Stanlake, 4 overs are looking quite competent. And you've got Siddharth Kaul. There are a couple of guys waiting in the wings who haven't even rolled their arm over. Someone like Huda, someone like Yusuf. They do have plenty of options with them. Plethora of quality bowling options. Is their batting that's been a bit of a concern? They've been chasing only middling totals and haven't always chased it with ease. So they will be tested against Kings 11 Punjab. Kings 11 Punjab, they do have Gale back. They have KL Rahul, they have Karun Nair. If Yuvraj Singh fires, well, they might just become unstoppable. It's very difficult for me to now look beyond KL Rahul. I've been a huge KL Rahul fan. The way he bats, he's also just signifying that good technique, actually technique, won't slow you down. It liberates you. It gives you more options to score runs. In fact, he has as many as two or at times three shots to the same ball, and he's playing all cricketing shots, and therefore he's consistent. He doesn't mind going aerial. That's another new way of modern day batting, where previously we were all told that the aerial shot over covers is just an extension of a cover drive, but not many people were able to execute it that nicely. But KL Rahul is different. Personally, I feel that he's the second most skilled Indian batsman across all formats. So KL Rahul is the batsman to watch out for. I'm going with Billy Stanlake this time around. He will be bowling to KL Rahul. He'll be bowling to Chris Gayle. There might be Aaron Finch in the middle, and then there'll be Karun Nair, Mayank Agarwal, and Yuvraj Singh. I am really looking forward to see how he bowls. He's got pace, he's got bounce, he's very tall. He will test the Indian batsman, but he will also make Chris Gayle's life slightly troublesome. So that's a battle. That's the mini battle within the big war between these two very good sides. Billy Stanlake, actually I'm thinking that he'll have a good game. I'm going with Shakib Al Hasan. Somebody who brings two disciplines to the table, and also the fact that Sunrisers Hyderabad have found a slightly better role for him to perform. He's getting to bat higher up in the order. He's been used very wisely by Kane Williamson with the ball. He is also batting well, and he is a banker when it comes to four overs or spin in the middle overs. They do have enough people to bowl in the power play and the death overs. At times you relax a little bit in the middle overs, but Shakib Al Hasan is ensuring that that doesn't happen. So he could be the trump card who's capable of turning the game in his side's favor. I'm going with Bhuvneshwar Kumar bowling to Chris Gayle. We've seen Chris Gayle bat the way he did last time around. He just took the attack apart. Chennai Super Kings, they had no answers when he was going strong. And on the other hand, you've got Bhuvneshwar Kumar, who enjoys these competitions or rivalries. I remember one game where Chris Gayle scored that 175 for RCB at Chinnaswamy against Pune Warriors India. Bhuvneshwar was a part of that squad as well, and gave away, if my memory is serving me right, only 23 runs in 4 overs that he bowled. So he's got the swing, swings the ball both ways in the air, will pitch the ball fuller, will ask you tough questions, got a wonderful knuckleball, or will mix in a bouncer. It'll be interesting to see whether the Indian spearhead of the bowling attack wins this battle, or the Jamaican is still firing. Once again, it's going to be a very tough game to predict. You've got Kings 11 Punjab that has shown signs of all the good work they did in the auctions. They do have a formidable squad. And Sunrisers Hyderabad, the best bowling team in the tournament, but they are yet to lose a game. So you also know that averages may just catch up at some stage. They might just slip up. They've been slightly shaky chasers, but they haven't been the bowling actually has not forced them to chase a big total. Since I have to pick, I'll go with Sunrisers Hyderabad. I always go with the team that has a better bowling lineup.